get to what you call being on the main event, right?
The main event.
Last game of the weekend. Rex Ryan, having fun, smiling, Bill Belichick. That's how he comes prepared. Antonio Cromartie.
Florida State.
After a malfunction comment towards Tom Brady. There we go. Wes Welker didn't start because of the stealth foot bombing.
Punish me with my pocket.
Don't hurt me. So Wes Welker was not out for the first set of downs for the Patriots. He was standing and watching Rob Gronkowski playing in his first career playoff game with a big chain mover there. And then Tom Brady makes a rare mistake. His first interception in 339 attempts with
Algie. Come on, Algie. Come on, Algie.
And Algie Crumpler makes a big touchdown saving tackle. What was the mistake here that Brady made?
Tom had to throw this ball over the top of Calvin Pace's arm. Throw a little free throw in there. He dropped it down. David Harris, nice play. What great hustle, though, by Crumpler.
And that was huge because the Jets began to figuratively shoot themselves in the foot as Sanchez and Sean Green trip over
that
one another.
That happened in the playoffs.
And then after that happens, Green comes out, LT comes in, and Sanchez dumps it off to LaDainian, who gets tackled by his offensive line.
Oh, well, they're good tacklers.
This is great play recognition so by the Patriots.
At least they're going to get 3 points out of
it. Just kick it, all right?
It's an easy. This guy brought him into the game, and Nick Folk puts a cherry on top.
Is that the same Folk who won it?
Wait a minute. Won it last week.
It looked like it might be good. Rex doesn't challenge
the upright.
It.
Is it over the upright? Should be good, then.
The refs are
no challenge, though. You don't challenge that.
Brady's mistake leads to no points. Still scoreless with 4 minutes to go in the half. First quarter part.
Wes is back.
Wes is back off of the bench.
Suspension.
Well, I guess he even returned the first punt, so it really wasn't that long that he stayed there. Brady begins to get things going on right now. Finds Algie Crumpler.
Methodical drive.
28-yard gain.
That's a big man.
Seventh play of the drive. Ninth play of the drive. Brady looks for the big man in the end zone, but Crumpler.
Oh, come on, Algie.
Make that play.
Big drop.
Gave him an opportunity. Just did not come up with the play.
Next play, Sean Ellis. Coming up with a big sack of Tom Brady. The Jets were able to get pressure with their front four, and it caused Brady and the Patriots to settle for a field goal there instead of getting a touchdown. It's just 3-0 New England. Sanchez, after having no offensive touchdowns in the first quarter again, points for Braylon Edwards to go upfield, and he finds his big receiver.
Nice extending the play, directing that traffic over there, Braylon to the sideline.
And then 2 plays later, LaDainian Tomlinson's first touchdown reception in 2 years.
It's the play that the Patriots used against the Jets last time. The Jets says, let me put it on you.
First touchdown of the game belongs to the Jets at LT. It's 7-3, 9 minutes to go.
Everybody's home.
Brady can't find anybody, and he's forced to throw it towards Gronkowski, and it was a coverage.
He's very uncomfortable moving out of the pocket. The guys are plastering the receivers, which means go to your man when he starts to move out of the pocket.
Jets next. Possession, 7-3. Santonio Holmes is open, and who breaks it up?
The guy from Michigan, Braylon Edwards.
Braylon Edwards makes a nice defensive play.
Doing there together anyway?
Should be there.
Sanchez is upset because they're forced to punt, but the defense again holds as Brady cannot come up with points in a situation he normally does, but less than 2 minutes before the half. And then what do the Patriots do? They go for a fake punt in their own end, down by 4, and it doesn't work as Patrick Chung muffs it.
One of these gutsy calls to fake punt it in your own territory. If it works, you look like a genius. If it doesn't work, hang on now, because you could give up some points.
What would the Jets do with this
opportunity? You lost your mind. We get all the way here, and you're going to pull that mess on me? That's what he said.
So what does Sanchez and the Jets do with this opportunity? LT in between the tackles, right to the edge of the red zone. 16-yard gain of the 21. 3 plays later, 3rd and 5 in the red zone. Braylon Edwards makes a catch and then makes a play.
It says, I want to go to an AFC championship game more than you do. That's what Braylon Edwards in this play says. Look at it. It's about who wants it more.
You take Merriweather and McCourty, 2 Pro Bowlers, into the end zone with you. Great play, Braylon.
14-3, Jets on top of the half, and then the first possession of the second half, the Jets take the law firm and shut it down. David Harris and Bart Scott stop him on short yardage, but the Jets give the ball back to the Patriots. And here comes Calvin Pace, sacking Brady again.
Enough time to throw the ball, but no one's open once again. Great job on the back end of the Jets.
Boy, that front end got there.
Forced the fumble, but the Patriots fortunate to recover it. Jets get the ball back. 3rd play of the possession. Sean Green runs between the tackles here for a 20-yard gain to the Patriots, 42. 3 plays later, can Sanchez and the Jets tack on points to this 11-point lead with 4 minutes to go in the third quarter? They cannot, as Sanchez overthrows Cotchery. Sanchez was high with his throws in the first quarter, got things buttoned up in the second quarter. Third quarter, he couldn't come up with the crucial throw there, and Brady and the Patriots began to click on offense to the best they had all day. Gronkowski right up the seam, 37 yards. Perfect. 3 plays later, third and 9, Deion Branch makes a play.
What an effort right here by Deion Branch, who Darrell Reeves had done a great job on all day getting involved.
12-yard gain on third and 9. 3 plays later, Brady to Wes Welker.
Boom! Watch that hit. And remember that hit. It will have an effect later.
As pieces come off the helmet, Eric Smith unloads on the Patriots' good little foot soldier. Next play, Brady looking for the big man again in the end zone. And Algie Crumpler holds on this time. And it's 14-9. Why are we mentioning that score? Because what does the book say?
The chart says go for two if it's late.
Only if it's Bill Belichick's chart. And what a great play. Sammy Morris comes in the backfield, and Brady hands it off to him for the two-point conversion.
I like it. I like it.
A direct snap, what a footy. Fooled the whole defense. We're expecting a pass in that situation. Great call by Belichick.
It was a direct snap. So Morris gets the two-point conversion. It's just a three-point game to start the fourth quarter. How do the Jets respond? By hitting Jericho Cotchery over the middle. Cotchery is still going. Cotchery leaps over the wall. Nice job by Jericho. And he is down.
This should never happen again. Zone coverage. Somebody ought to be there to make a play.
He missed the tackle.
58-yard gain. 3 plays later. Holy Super Bowl 43, Batman. Santonio Holmes makes a play in the corner of the end zone in a big playoff game. Touchdown, Jets. Holmes got one knee down and one knee.
Get it down.
2 feet. Yes. 9 less feet than what Wes Welker said on the podium.
Some people are born to make big plays in this situation, and that's exactly what Santonio Holmes has been born for.
The Jets with a 10-point lead now with 10 minutes to go, and that's when the Brady and the Patriots went on a methodical drive down the field. Deion Branch with an 8-yard gain on 3rd and 6.
And he's talking junk.
6 plays later, 12th play of the drive, Tom Brady to...
You got enough time.
Somebody.
But no one's open. You had enough time. Once again,
four man rush.
It's a coverage sack. 13th play of the drive. It's 3rd and 13. Tom Brady.
Got enough time.
Checks it down to Danny Woodhead eventually.
Have enough time.
And Brady.
Have enough time.
And the Patriots.
No one's open.
Wow. Cannot complete it. Wow. So it's 4th and 13 with 5 minutes and 19 ticks left. And it's another great play by the
secondary. This is a cover two. Two safeties deep. 4 or 5 underneath, and everyone's plastering on the receiver.
So Darrell Revis had to come out due to injury. It's 4th and 13. Revis isn't on the field, and Brady and Branch cannot connect. And the Patriots turn down the field goal with a wind in their face and 52 yards. Instead, they go for it and come up empty on a drive that lasted 7.5 minutes.
The drive lasted too long, and you don't make that play.
But the Jets cannot get a first down with 3 minutes and 40 seconds to go, and the Patriots only call their first timeout of the half there. So they've got 2 timeouts left, and now the ball, and Julian Edelman running up the seam on a punt return.
He's out of their lane on punt coverage, and the punter has to make the tackle and save the day.
What was the design? He just got it and hit that hole, coach.
41-yard punt return, setting the Patriots up, shot on the plus side of the field again. Gronkowski now takes the Patriots inside the red zone. 3 plays later, 3rd and 10, Tom Brady with 2.5 minutes to go, needing to score right before the 2-minute warning.
Oh, to get out of it.
And that is a nice tackle by Drew Coleman, because Welker cannot get out of bounds, meaning it's time for Shane Graham to come in, hopefully to get the field goal off before the 2-minute warning so they could use it as a timeout if they should score. The 2-minute warning comes, and that's a good thing because Graham's kick is no good. Had it counted, the Patriots would have gotten no points, so they come back after the 2-minute warning and get the 3 crucial points necessary to set up an onside kick, and they go up the middle. The ball is free and loose. Who gets it?
We do not teach going down at Florida State. We go to the house.
I mean, instead of jumping on the ball, it's Antonio Cromartie.
Shut up.
The mad F-bomber of the week.
Hey.
It gets this through Darrell Revis, and he kicks it. And he runs it
which came right to him.
Which is crucial because the Patriots have only two timeouts left. Sean Green, two plays later.
Oh, Lynch makes it personal right here. You remember Marshawn Lynch last week, and now Sean Green in his face.
What's Rex Ryan doing in the end zone?
High stepping.
Watch this in his face. Look at this. Get out of here.
Well, Sean Green goes in the end zone, and he goes down to celebrate using the ball as a pillow. Just when you thought Rex was running down there to say, don't do it. It's going to cost us 15 yards.
Like he got an ankle weight on
there. He finally gets down there, and he celebrates. Rex.
Rex.
I think I could take him in
the
40.
You could take him.
We could hook that up now.
Or Sean Green could have gone down and ended the game. Jets could have taken a knee. Instead, Brady gets the ball back with less than a minute to go. And one timeout left still. And there's Danny Woodhead right around in the red zone. The Patriots with 30 ticks to go after using their final timeout. All sorts of time again. Brady finds Deion Branch in the end zone, meaning the Patriots have another shot with the onside kick. If they can get it, they get a Hail Mary. They can force overtime with the new overtime rules. But right up the gut again, the Jets hand team does fall on it this time. And that's the way they cartwheel their way.
We don't flip, Braylon.
Into the AFC Championship game for the second consecutive year, this time against the Pittsburgh Steelers. Rex and Belichick share an embrace and a conversation in the middle of the field. And the Jets, 6 weeks after losing by 42 points in that stadium, in front of the whole country, return in front of the whole country again and make the Patriots one and done in the AFC.